Hey, what's up, guys? This is Team Hard Life Captain Albert Zertuche. All right, now that everybody's eaten, we're putting out the extra effort to get the jet ski back into the water. And as you see, it's a team effort. Guys on the jet ski, we got a guy on the rack, we got a guy for taking the baits out to the jet skier and putting it all together. So we're going to do the last minute Hail Mary to get baits back into the water. And yeah, now that y'all have seen the underwater footage from earlier today, it does give us a big heads up of kind of what's going to happen next. I mean, do we really truly know? We're about to find out. Gotta fight, gotta fight.
I got a lot of stress on my mind. It's a nice day to go. Yeah, I got a line. I'ma call up the whole team.
He fell off already.
He fell off.
No, he gets off so he can hold on to it. Oh. All right, guys. So one at a time, our baits will be put back out. We literally have zero baits in the water. We're gonna attempt to rerun everything really quick, and since everything is already pre-rigged, we are gonna send them out and see how this works out. And we're starting with our first bait at a little past 10:11. It'll be 10:12, and let's see how this night goes. Guys, so while I'm up on the rack, I am giving some coaching and little tidbits of knowledge on what we're looking for while we're getting the baits out, especially at night, because it's even harder because the only guides that we have now are the rigs that are way out there and the lights that are actually on the jet ski, and that's basically all we have. You know, we're not allowed to shine light out into the water from the area we're at, because they can say that it can produce undue advantage over the fishing and stuff, even though there's no way it can penetrate 500 or 1,000 yards wherever our baits are. But at the same time, this is the spot where we decided to make a game changer. And for us, when we realized we're getting cut off at, you know, 600 or more yards from the beach, we decided to make a judgment call and run our baits out 500 yards and, you know, shorter, just because we're hoping to hold on to these leaders a bit longer than we did the last time, which would enable us to hook up to a monster shark. So in this process, like I said, we're shooting for 500 yards to 6, and yeah, we're gonna see how it goes from here. But like I said, you know, it's always thinking outside the box and on the fly and adapting and overcoming what is presented in front of you. Right here, we had already dropped the first bait. We were on to the second bait, and this one already got cut off. This one was probably the farthest bait because we're, like I said, we're still shooting for about the 500 to 600 yards. This was closer to 600. So, yep, it's already cut off. And you're gonna see that underwater footage of all those sharks. Have we seen that footage? Earlier on, we may have made a judgment call to go to 400 or, you know, a little bit less just to see that we can keep baits in the water and wait for the big one to come through. And so right here, we got this first cutoff. And like I said, we were down to our last 6 to 7 liters. So we also started to make a judgment call, starting to pull back. So instead of 500 to 600, we're going to go 400 to 500, you know, 450, 500, and let's see how that works out for us.
Come on.
There you go, another rod down. Golly, as fast as we're getting them out, they seem to be getting cut off, and it is it's painful. So we're dropping back from 450 and 500, and yeah, we're gonna go to 450 and keep testing it, go as far as we can.
But also too, not too far, but hopefully we can hold on to some of these leaders so we can catch a big shark and put it on deck.
Thank you.
wide pattern, and they zero in on it, you know what I mean? So if the line comes down, or the current comes down range, he's coming this way looking for it. So depending on which way he's going,
like the
that or if you're not even in the lane finder mix, he's just swimming through.
Laser.
Yeah.
And he said there was a zero on the bait out there.
Oh, yeah. So.
Thirty-nine minutes, and we've already lost four or five rigs.
Well, we lost three. Well, we're coming up.
Yeah.
Okay. So I was finally able to get back onto this video and get it posted up, but yes sir, so all the work that went into it to get the lines out and to see so many of them get lost while we were in the process, it's just it is.